Hey, this is Dr. K from iMedicalSchool, and today we're going to discuss a step one practice question. So let's get started. The question is, a 56-year-old male with a past medical history of hypertension, diabetes, and hyperlipidemia presents with new onset painless jaundice without associated abdominal pain. Vital signs are normal. Basic labs are drawn and are shown. The total bilirubin is 9.2, direct is 7.8, albumin is 3.8, ALT is 130, AST is 146, and alkaline phosphatase is 405. What is the next best step for this patient? Is it A, HIDA scan, B, right upper quadrant ultrasound, C, ERCP, D, IV antibiotics, or E, emergent cholecystectomy? Take a few moments and pause here to think about the question and come up with your answer. All right, let's talk about the correct answer. The correct answer is right upper quadrant ultrasound. Let's talk about why B is the best answer. Whenever someone presents with painless jaundice, it is really cancer until proven otherwise. To identify the cancer or the cause of the obstruction, we need imaging. A HIDA scan is a very good test to identify obstruction, but given that it has a greater specificity and less sensitivity, we generally do a right upper quadrant ultrasound. If the right upper quadrant ultrasound is negative, but the clinical suspicion is high, then we could consider a HIDA scan. In terms of urgent surgery, there is no need for an emergent cholecystectomy, as the patient is normotensive and has no red flag signs to indicate a cholecystectomy. IV antibiotics would be indicated if the patient had cholangitis. Cholangitis usually presents with the symptoms and signs in Charcot's or Raynaud's pentad. Charcot's triad is fever, right upper quadrant pain, and jaundice. Raynaud's pentad is Charcot's triad plus hypotension and altered mental status. Given the patient does not meet these criteria, antibiotics should not be administered. Finally, let's talk about ERCP. ERCP is a procedure that can identify blockages of the biliary tract from stones or masses and then open up these blockages. Before obtaining an ERCP, you need an ultrasound to identify the location and likely cause for the obstruction. This is why, before doing any intervention, we generally obtain a right upper quadrant ultrasound, given it's a cheap, non-interventional test that can provide a great deal of information. So really, when anyone presents with jaundice, we generally know the biliary tract or liver is being infected in some way. So the first step is almost always to obtain a right upper quadrant ultrasound. Now let's talk about how to interpret abnormal liver function tests. If a patient has a transaminitis that is an elevated AST and ALT, we need to determine if the patient has a cholestatic or non-cholestatic liver pattern. Cholestatic means that there is an obstruction either from a gallstone, mass, stricture, or inflammation. Non-cholestatic generally indicates a process that is affecting the liver and not the biliary tract. So let's briefly review the biliary tract. The liver empties into the hepatic duct and the gallbladder empties into the cystic duct, with both creating the common bile duct. The pancreas empties into the common bile duct, which empties into the duodenum. When there's an obstruction in the common bile duct or hepatic duct, this can lead into a transaminitis due to backup, and you may also get an elevated alkaline phosphatase. Now, the biggest question is how to differentiate between a non-cholestatic and cholestatic liver pattern. To differentiate between these patterns, look at the alkaline phosphatase. If a alkaline phosphatase is significantly higher than the levels of transaminases, I generally consider this to be a cholestatic picture. If not, then it is non-cholestatic. Now remember, biliary obstruction is not the only part of the body that can cause an elevation in alkaline phosphatase. Alkaline phosphatase can be increased by anything that affects the gut, bone, as well as the uterus. We can identify biliary versus other causes by obtaining a GGT. If the GGT is high, this indicates that the alkaline phosphatase is likely due to biliary obstruction. In addition, we can also identify if the alkaline phosphatase is of biliary origin if we fractionate the alkaline phosphatase. Fractionating the alkaline phosphatase identifies how much of the alkaline phosphatase comes from bone, gut, uterus, or the biliary tree. In today's case, we have an elevated ALT and AST with an elevated alkaline phosphatase higher than the transaminases with jaundice. So this indicates a cholestatic pattern. Remember, jaundice workup almost always begins with a right upper quadrant ultrasound. All right, that was a brief review. So if you enjoyed this video, share this video with your friends on Facebook and Twitter. You can follow us on Twitter at iMedSchool. search iMedicalSchool on Facebook and you can follow us on our Facebook page. Like, comment with any suggestions or questions, and subscribe. This is Dr. K. I'll see you next time.